Hello everyone, HPI Guys Model Workshop here with a kit review of the re-released AMT Star Trek Exploration set. In this kit, you will get the phaser, the communicator, and the tricorder from the original TV series. These are not full size though, it kind of bums some people out. These are one-third scale. I think they're like one-third off the size of the regular ones, so they're not as big as you'd like them to be, but as you'll see, they're not a bad size, and it's pretty much the only option you have unless you want to buy something that's pre-made, or if you want to spend a lot more money on an actual studio replica kit from companies that make those, and you're going to pay a lot more than I paid for this kit. What I paid for this kit was $21, and I think it was plenty worth it. It's more for the nostalgia factor and the sci-fi geek, and I haven't reviewed a whole lot of sci-fi stuff on here, so I thought I'd give you guys a look at this that I picked up recently. So let's see everything that's in the box. There isn't a whole lot in there. You've got only two colors of plastic. You've got chrome and you've got black. First, we'll show you the chrome tree. And that's it right there. And let's bring this down a little bit so it's not so difficult to see everything in front. We'll move that there. The chrome tree is done pretty darn well. That's the communicator, the flip-up part of the communicator, and it is supposed to have a rougher texture to it. And you can paint these. Take a look online at the actual original colors of the equipment and paint them accordingly, dull coat them or clear coat them with future as needed, because some of these parts weren't chrome. There's the ends of the phaser, and it is a requirement when you do shoot the phaser, when you build it, that you make the pew pew noise. It's not, I didn't make the rule, guys. It is a requirement when you work with anything sci-fi, when you build an X-Wing fighter, when you build a Enterprise, when you build phasers and tricorders, you have to make the noise. It's just the rule, so you're going to have to do it. The black parts in the kit, these are parts for the phaser. You can see they have a nice texture molded on them. And there's your handle. And then that's got a nice grip texture built into it. Let me let you focus on that. And then you got the top of the phaser with the dial. Set it to stun, set it to kill, set it to vaporize. Do your business, boys. You know, Kirk always accidentally set it to vaporize and turn a guy into particles, because that's just what Kirk did. Here's your communicator. And, of course, you'll need the chrome part that flips up. And, once again, you are required to make the noise when you do it. Great texture on there, that great vinyl-look texture. Of course, in the future, it would have been space-age materials. So that's really cool. And then you've got the parts for the tricorder here. And those will just snap together, pretty much glue together like so. So you can see the size of that. Makes a respectable size tricorder. You'll be inserting numerous chrome pieces in here, like a TV screen and a dial and a thing to sample the chemicals that they put in it behind that little closed in window there. And then on the top, you know, you'll have the flip up TV screen and everything that they had, and then just the small accessory parts that help you assemble the tricorder. No real flash on this stuff to speak of, no problems. When you get done assembling them out of the box, they will look like so, and that's where I said look up the colors for painting so you can get a better guesstimation on how to paint those up. There's only one thing left in the entire kit. I told you there's not much here at all. And we'll look at the directions in a minute, but that's the new and improved decal set so that you can actually have some color on the screen. Look at him. He's like, "Oh, you're looking at me." And, it, you know, you got your graph there, and then you've got your little communicator button, the little psychedelic thing right by my thumb there. So that's all some cool stuff. The manual, you wouldn't even, if you lost the manual to this thing, you would be able to put it together. It's only one page. There's nothing really to it at all whatsoever. You've got your communicator here. Your communicator consists of four parts. And it's all decaling and detailing at that point, painting it up to look the way you want it to. The phaser is not that much different at all. The phaser's got two parts for the handle, two parts for the body, your upper area with your stun and kill dial, and then your two snap together parts for the chrome end on the phaser, where the actual phase comes out. Then you've got your tricorder which has your little tape deck door, your TV screen and controls, and then that'll flip up and down on its axles, so you can actually move it around. And then you're just your backing cover. So, you know, you're going to end up snapping this all together in just a few minutes. You wouldn't even spend 30 minutes snapping everything, all three of them together. And then the rest is just going to be detail painting, shading, and shadowing to make them look real. You know, you can paint the body of the phaser like a light grayish blue. You can do the chrome cover on the communicator in a goldish. If you did it like in a clear gold, that would actually come out real good with the chrome. And then you can detail all the little lights with transparent colors underneath the chrome, or you could drill them out. All of these are more than large enough. You could see the insides, especially the tricorder. You could see the insides of these that you could easily put batteries and LED lights in every single one of these. Even this, even the communicator, when it's snapped together, you've got over a quarter inch of space in there, a little bit more, once you put that chrome piece right in here, you know, and push it through. So you could even put a coin cell in here and run some surface mount diodes through the holes and light this thing up. So that wouldn't be difficult at all. That would be your choice. Maybe I'll even try that. Maybe if I do decide to light them up and stuff, I'll do a build, and I'll have to reference some other guys' videos on here on YouTube that are really good with SMDs, like Classic Plastic 101. I'll have to get a little tutorial from him on how to work with those again. But set them up to blink and all that. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys pick this kit up. If you're a Star Trek fan, it's definitely worth $20, $21. And once again, thanks for watching HPI Guys Model Workshop.